Howdy there. So yesterday I watched Alice in Wonderland, the live action 2010 version. It's the second time I watched it. I'm going to give it a 7. I think it's, you know, pretty fantastic. I rented it because basically Alice in Wonderland and Inception were the big technical Oscar nominees this year, and it actually kind of split all of the awards it was nominated for with Inception, which kind of surprised me. I thought Inception was just kind of gonna take everything, when Alice in Wonderland actually took a few key technical awards. So I was like, wow, okay. I knew I needed to at least see it again just to appreciate that aspect. And it is, you know, beautifully made. It looks amazing. I wish there were some heart to match. I think that's what's missing here. And usually Tim Burton can make a cold, distant, alienating film and then wrap it up with some very human heart in it. And I feel that the heart that comes at the end of this story is more forced, tacked on in something you would see as what this is, which is a, you know, blockbuster, an event picture. So as an event picture, I think it really serves the purpose well. I mean, it tells a quality story in an eye-popping fashion. Let's see, it's about Alice. Alice, since her first adventures in Wonderland, has grown, I guess 13 years some, has grown 13 years older and goes back to Wonderland with no memory of it. She meets all of the Wonderland characters that you are used to. Again, it's basically a retelling of the Alice in Wonderland story. It's taken, adapted from two Lewis Carroll books. I guess it's Adventures in Underland and Through the Looking Glass. I've never read the books, so I don't know how true to them this film is. Let's see. Written by Linda Wolverton. I've never heard that name before. And directed by Tim Burton. He did not produce this film, actually. He just directed it. You definitely see his mark here. It's a Tim Burton film. Stars, again, Tim Burton favorites. Johnny Depp. Helena Bonham Carter. Crispin Glover. And Mia, what's her name? Who is Alice? Mia Wasikowski. She was also in The Kids Are All Right last year. She had a big year last year. Those are, like, basically the only four humans in the bulk of the story. The rest are concoctions, special effects creations. Of course, voiced by humans. I would say sometimes maybe motion captured by humans, but I'm not entirely certain. But as for the voice cast, there's a lot of people there I know. I can't tell you any off the top of my head, though. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous production design. I mean, that's what you know you're going to get with the Tim Burton film, is a gorgeous-looking film. And this looks pretty good. I'd say, with the exception of, I don't know what they had to do to get it into 3D. This was released in 3D. I saw it in 2D in the theater because the 3D conversion process removes a lot of the color, and I knew that this film would be wall-to-wall color, so why would you want that reduced? And I don't know if they knew that they were going to shoot in 3D. I think maybe they did, maybe they reshot. But I thought some of the 3D moments were a little distracting, maybe tacky, even on the home screen, you know. Even in some parts, I thought the special effects looked a little shoddy. You know, just like too obviously green screen. You know, usually what's there to blend or make it seem like it's all on one plane, or I don't know kind of how I'm needing to describe that. It's just you can really, really tell that they're in front of a green screen. And only in certain parts where I thought that they may have redesigned the scene for 3D. Anyway, I don't know. Still a really good watch. It's a 7. I think the technical merits of this film outweigh any of the faults. Again, I just had a problem with how Alice came to great life realizations, epiphanies. I mean, yeah, she had to defeat a dragon, but I don't know. I just didn't really see the journey. Whenever the film is about the Wonderland characters, the Queen of Hearts, the Mad Hatter, the Cheshire Cat is awesome. He's probably my favorite part. I don't know who did the voice of the Cheshire Cat, but great stuff. Whenever the film is about them, whenever it's giving backstory to their problems, I really enjoyed it a lot more. There's, I think, more attention to that aspect of the story. And not about Alice. I thought Helena Bonham Carter as the Queen of Hearts was great. She's very funny. I thought her, I really liked her character. Again, also one of my favorite parts, and she, you know, she's a bad lady. And I thought, oh, Anne Hathaway. Anne Hathaway plays one of the other humans. She's like unaffected, kind of, by special effects. But anyway, the Red Queen, Queen of Hearts, very funny character. And Helena Bonham Carter plays her very well. She's a great actress. And Johnny Depp's Mad Hatter is fantastic, colorful, insane. Just sometimes, I don't know, I wanted to just keep staring at his face because it just seemed to me like his makeup or his eyes would change like as you watched him. And I was just like, Johnny Depp, there's always something to watch in a Johnny Depp performance. He really is one of our best actors, craziest actors, riskiest actors. And risk usually comes with reward. But yeah, just staring at his face or the contacts, maybe it was just the contacts he had to wear. Just something's captivating about just staring at his face in this film. Really, I think that's about it. Again, it's a solid 7. I'm sure you've seen the movie. If not, definitely rent it. You know, check it out sometime. Especially if you like Alice in Wonderland or Johnny Depp or just fantasy tales. It's definitely worth your time. So that's Alice in Wonderland. I wish it had more heart, but it's got a lot for your head. I wish it had more for the heart. So it's Alice in Wonderland. It's a 7. Check it out. Thanks.